There was no welfare back then. They planted their gardens, they fished, and they hunted. And they would fry the meat and salt the fish and smoke them. They had a mill there, and they used to work at the mill. At that time, there was very few Indians that was hired for any kind of labor. They would hire them for weeding gardens or hoeing or work at the mill to pile lumber up. In summertime, when the school closed, they all traveled down to Majorville, where the farms are, and this is where they would weed and hoe. In the summertime, you would hardly find anyone at the village. They'd take their canoes, tents, and they'd go along. They'd camp here and there along the river. In that time, there was no money exchanged. You get paid by food, bread, potatoes, and the farmers used to smoke their own pork, salt their pork, ham, and whatever. And this is what you would get for your pay, and eggs and stuff like that. I left school when I was in grade 4. I was just around, I guess, wherever anyone wants to keep me or feed me. When you're left alone and the family scatters and the parents died, you just kept wandering here and there. I remember I stayed with my brother for a while with his wife, Bagun, and they had a baby. I don't know what happened. I was really young. But I know the baby bled to death because the doctor came from Fredericton to Ormocto and it was winter time. So it took a long, long time. Oh yes, they'd make baskets, axe handles, wenochwe ankumtug, which means go sell for potatoes, turnips, meat, and all that, a bartering system. They never got money for it, the baskets. They would go trade. That was their way. When there was a sick man, these people would come and they'd all gather the food from the neighborhood, whatever one could give, and put it in a big basket. They'd go to this man's house and they'd chant something like, Bejiptun Nidup, I bring to you, my male friend. And they had rattles from cow horns and they had little rocks in it. And they would rattle it and they'd dance around. They'd put this basket in the middle of the floor and they'd dance around it. And then they dance right out. And the next day, a couple of men would come and chop wood for this man and get some water for the woman until that man is well. In those days, you respect your elders. Almost everyone was your grandmother because that's what you called them, Nokmus. I don't care who it is. If you are related to them or not, you call them Nokami or Musami, grandfather. In those days, we had a visiting priest who would come once a month to Ormocto. It would put all modern Catholics to shame the way the Indians were. I remember Kchiskehewatuk, Good Friday. There was little brook down there in Ormocto and a little bridge. That's where the Indians in Ormocto used to get their water from, this little brook. They had a hole there. They would get us up at 3 a.m. to pray by this little brook. We don't care if it was cold or stormy. We'd get out of bed and go pray by that little brook. You'd drink that water and bless yourself. That priest, you would think that he was God himself. They worshipped him so much. They respected him so much. I can't carry a whole conversation in Indian, but I wish I could speak it fluently. It's strange. I could never speak a word of English when I first came up here. I could say yes or I don't know, and that was it. And now I don't remember my Indian. I used to be able to name all the trees, all the animals, river. My prayers was in Indian, the Our Father, the Hail Mary. It was all Indian, and now nothing. I don't think I could even bless myself in Indian.